My name is Amandeep, working in the field of artificial intelligence and automotive. Today I'm going to talk about artificial intelligence, its use cases, and how management studies are impacted with this. So artificial intelligence is the ability of a machine to perform cognitive functions we associate with human minds, such as perceiving, reasoning, learning, interacting with the environment, problem solving, and even exercising creativity. AI presents opportunities to complement and supplement human intelligence and enrich the way people live and work. Andrew Ng, the co-founder of Coursera and formerly head of Baidu AI group, Google Brain, compares the transformational impact of AI to that of electricity 100 years back. With many industries aggressively investing in cognitive and AI solutions, the global investments are forecasted to achieve a CAGR of about 50% to reach US$57.6 billion in 2021. Examples of technologies that enable AI to solve business problems are robotics, autonomous vehicles, computer vision, natural language processing, virtual agents, and machine learning. AI is not a new phenomenon, with much of its theoretical and technological underpinning developed over the past 70 years by computer scientists and AI researchers. Raphael, in his book The Thinking Computer, defines artificial intelligence as a computerized system that exhibits behavior, which is commonly thought of as requiring intelligence. On the other hand, Alan Turing, the founding father of artificial intelligence, says AI is the science and engineering of making intelligent machines, especially the intelligent computer programs. Both convey the same message, that giving cognitive abilities to computers and machines is called artificial intelligence. There is three type of artificial intelligence: narrow artificial intelligence, artificial general intelligence, and artificial super intelligence. First, talking about artificial narrow intelligence, which is developed and trained for a particular task, and it has the capability of doing that task at a perfect level. Some examples are sales prediction and purchase suggestions, weather forecasting, or implementation of narrow artificial intelligence. The problem with narrow artificial intelligence is that it cannot scale to do the task beyond its field, which means that if it is trained to do task A, it cannot do task B. For example, image recognition AI engine cannot perform sales recommendations. Now, talking about second type, that is artificial general intelligence. These are the AI systems with generalized cognitive abilities, which find solutions to the unfamiliar task it come across. So these systems have the ability of doing tasks across the domains for which it is even not trained. They can understand and reason the environment as a human would do. Number three, artificial super intelligence, which is the top level of artificial intelligence that has the cognitive capabilities comparable to humans, or maybe more than a human would have. So these are computers or machines that will surpass humans, and machines would be able to mimic the human thoughts. To take it forward, cognitive ability of machines will be superior to the humans. So we have not yet achieved artificial super intelligence, and we are far, far away from achieving the artificial super intelligence right now. Some examples that researchers say are comparable to artificial super intelligence are IBM's Watson supercomputer and assistive devices like Siri, Echo, which are close to artificial superintelligence, but these are not really the artificial superintelligence that we can say. Now, every big and complex technology system is built up of multiple components, which we define as a building blocks. So AI is not different, and there are several building blocks of AI that we will talk about. At the top of the curve is machine learning, which is the science of using statistical methods and mathematical algorithms to train computers to do specific tasks. For example, identifying frauds, identifying spam emails, and identifying images. They give the thinking or cognitive capability to artificial intelligence. It forms the basis of most of the AI systems and AI algorithms. So AI algorithms are not natively intelligent. If we say that those are dumb to start with, it would not be the smaller word. So they are not natively intelligent. They start with the naked algorithm that becomes intelligent only upon being trained on large amounts of data. Deep learning is a newer technique to do machine learning tasks with greater accuracy and precision. It uses neural networks based techniques to generate insights on the data. AI is an important enabling factor in the design and operationalization of smart robots and other process automation applications. Key aspect of robotics is that it combines hardware, which is mechanical parts, sensors, screens, etc., with intelligent software and data to perform a task for which certain level of intelligence is required. For example, orientation, motion, interaction, etc. Artificial intelligence needs strong support from philosophy that helps clarify the goals of artificial intelligence, concepts it uses, and kind of knowledge and ontology machine needs to interact with human. How do we enable artificial intelligence? So, in order for artificial intelligence to behave at the cognitive level, we need to enable with various components. An AI system combines and utilizes many machine learning and other types of data analytics methods to achieve cognitive capabilities. Technology plays key role in enabling artificial intelligence. Web technologies, cloud and APIs provides implementation capabilities. Internet of things and sensors help in data collection from the source objects. Key enabler without which no cognitive ability can be built is data, rather than we can say large amount of data. In the past, low level of cognitive ability driven by using small amount of data and rule-based data analytics programs, statistical methods and early expert systems are possible. But now, with the explosion of data and explosion of advanced techniques like deep neural networks or deep learning, AI gets something a mere program doesn't have, which is the ability to do the unexpected. Now, let us talk about some use cases of artificial intelligence. AI has the potential to impact and influence businesses and government sectors alike. We'll take a look at key impacts of AI on public sector in India and some critical business functions. So, starting with the public sector in India, Honorable Finance Minister in his budget speech for 2018-19 mandated Niti Aayog, which is the planning commission or the planning agency for Government of India, to establish national program on artificial intelligence with a view to guiding research and development in new and emerging technologies. In June 2018, discussion paper titled National Strategy for Artificial Intelligence focuses on how India can leverage the transformative technologies to ensure social and inclusive growth in line with development philosophy of the Government of India. Niti Aayog has decided to focus on five sectors that are envisioned to benefit the most from artificial intelligence in solving societal needs. These sectors are in healthcare. The vision is to provide increased access and affordability and quality healthcare. The vision of agriculture is to enhance farmers' income and increase farm productivity and reduce the wastage. In education, vision is to provide improved access and quality of education. For smart cities and infrastructure, target is to enable efficient connectivity for everyone and expanding human and the urban population. Smart mobility and transportation will provide smarter and safer modes of transportation and better traffic and congestion problems. In the world of business, some key business functions that can be enabled by artificial intelligence are marketing. So, using chatbots, personalized shopping recommendations and always available customer service can be delivered. This enhances the customer experience. Several techniques of prescriptive analytics, such as mathematical optimization, allows companies to optimize markdowns that in turn minimizes cannibalization while maximizing revenues. By leveraging capabilities of natural language processing and computer vision to understand the context where ads are to be placed, marketing can be context aware. In the case of product discovery, which can be enhanced by using computer vision to tag images as per customer's preferences and other relevant context. By leveraging neurosciences and biometric sensors data, the contents and ads effectiveness can be improved. In sales and sales operations, AI allows automatic and accurate sales forecasting based on all the customer contact points and previous sales outcomes. So this way, sales personnel can get more time doing the sales while allowing the system to do the accurate forecasting. Lead generation being critical part of sales process, AI helps generate efficient leads using a comprehensive data profile of various touch points. AI helps identify high potential companies or consumers that sales representatives need to connect to. AI algorithms could tell you what the ideal discount rate should be for a product based on festivals or customer loyalty. It also helps in maintaining dynamic pricing and surge-based pricing. AI can also help which of your existing customers are more likely to buy a better version of the product they already own, or which of the customers are more likely to want a new product that you are offering altogether. The net effect is an increase in revenue and a drop in marketing costs. Here also, chatbots can be the first line of interface to online or on-call customers. Although chatbots can be designed to serve customers in all possible way, but since achieving artificial general intelligence is difficult, chatbots may pass customers to human sales representatives if it cannot serve some of them. In financial technologies, financials or insurance, artificial intelligence helps in isolating the fraudulent or abnormal behavior by using customer profile data, the credit history, and other socioeconomic data. Insurance companies use artificial intelligence to detect customers' risk profile, quote optimal prices, manage claims effectively. A financial analytics platform comprising of machine learning, natural language processing, and other AI techniques can be used for financial analysis, algorithmic trading, and other investment strategies or tools. AI can be used for robust credit lending applications by using predictive models to uncover the potentially non-performing loans. It also helps in seeing a potential credit score of your customer before they apply for a loan and provide custom tailored plans. Using computer vision and NLP techniques, we can scan legal and regulatory texts and bulk of other paperwork to check compliance issues. All this without human involvement, thus saving a lot of cost and improving the operations. Now talking about the healthcare, which is the critical part of Government of India's initiative. So AI is helping doctors analyze a much wider span of data and do predictions with greater granularity and precision. With huge data and medical knowledge base, new drug combinations are being discovered that are personalized for a patient's specific needs. Medicare can be further personalized by using patient's medical history, genetic profile to get the best treatment plans according to patient's data. Using advanced AI techniques, it is now possible to detect critical diseases like cancer, hence helping doctors by being the first line of defense. Artificial intelligence ensures that healthcare can eventually be delivered at a lower cost because when efficiency is increased, diagnostics will be more focused. Artificial intelligence-based digital nurses are being experimented that can help monitor patients' condition and follow up with treatments between doctors' visits. The system can support patients for specialized chronic illness as well. Now, what are the employment and business opportunities for artificial intelligence? We'll explore some of the reports here. So the opportunities for management students in AI are tremendous, and we'll explore those now. Artificial intelligence is opening new workplaces for professionals, where technical professionals can explore new opportunities in building intelligent systems using technologies that we have discussed earlier. Management professionals can leverage their business knowledge to enable these intelligent systems for business use. Artificial intelligence consulting is an emerging field where such consultants help the businesses use artificial intelligence capabilities to improve their businesses or create new businesses. In the current state, companies are facing numerous challenges in adopting AI effectively, some of which are lack of AI strategy, lack of talent, lack of awareness, and even lack of willpower to explore the blue ocean strategy. AI technology is also not evolved completely, hence importance of experimentation and prototyping has increased in this world of AI. A recent report by Capgemini Consulting presents this problem. In this diagram, lower right quadrant, which is must do quadrant, many companies miss the chance to implement low complex and high beneficial artificial intelligence use cases. As per the report, 54% of the firms in this quadrant have not implemented the suggested use case yet, which can be most beneficial for them, that we call as a low-hanging fruits. Another report from a recent survey by Boston Consulting Group and MIT Sloan Review reflects on how business expects AI to help them by 2022, that is 5 years from the publication of this report in 2017. AI is expected to have great impact on their offerings and processes. Business expects AI to help in reducing inefficiencies and processes and generate new AI-enabled offerings. So now we are talking about new businesses, new products which are supported by artificial intelligence. Now let us talk about key activities and roles within the job function of AI consulting. Broadly speaking, an AI consulting assignment has three pillars: strategy, implementation, and training. In strategy formulation, it is important to understand the business strategy, challenges, and opportunities faced by the company. Customers' data and analytical capabilities also need to be assessed to understand the current state of those technological capabilities within the customer organization. Combining these with an understanding of the state of art artificial intelligence, a consultant can identify the most important AI initiatives for the company. Implementation comprises of multiple activities such as planning, vendor selection if needed, project and integration management, development, testing, deployment, change management, and other activities required to make the AI system operationalizable. In training, AI consulting projects need to ensure that business teams are capable and knowledgeable about the technologies they will be using in the future, which are AI enabled. Consultants work with the business to help them get familiarized with AI based systems. So that way they are making sure that the systems that they are delivering, that they are building for the companies, those are being used effectively by the business functions. Now, AI consultants need to have some skills in order to be successful in their field. So we will talk about some of the skills that not only helps professionals succeed in their jobs, but also helps in doing the job the right way. Although management students do not need deep technical skills and hands-on work as AI consultant, a high-level understanding of technical skills will surely help them be more effective. However, managerial skills such as product management, agile development, and portfolio management are needed for an AI consultant. These skills can help them be a holistic consultant who can apply system thinking in order to deliver value to their customers. So, in the past few minutes, we have explored the field of artificial intelligence at a high level, where we have talked about the components of artificial intelligence, the use cases both in public and private sector, and also the new emerging field for the management professionals and technical professionals, where they can tap the opportunities, get new employment, and help the companies tap the benefits of artificial intelligence. So, with these points, I hope you would be able to get some value out of artificial intelligence, especially the last slide where we talk about skills needed. Those are really critical for management students in order to excel in the field of AI consulting.